it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second and 2, Brady, he'll set up the screen to Fournette. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Now they'll have it first and goal following that gain of 17. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Shotgun now for Brady. It's caught. And it's 8-0. So what do you make of that? You go on the road, you score the opening drive touchdown, opt to go for 2, and all of a sudden they're up 8-0.
Yeah, this wasn't a decision that they made right here and right now. They made this decision during the week. Hey, if we get the ball and score right away, let's show them that we feel like we're superior, go for 2 and really put the pressure on them.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
First carry now for the former Badger, Jonathan Taylor. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
A gain of 4.
They run with Taylor. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
He was brought down by Levante David.
Third and short yardage, Brissett. And he's got his man, Hilton. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
Room here to run. 20. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there for Indy. 44 yards. They'll run here with Mack. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up second and goal. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Here's Brissett. And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. T.Y. Hilton there to make the grab. And the Colts are a 2-point conversion away from tying this football game. And it's up and good. So maybe a bit early here to try to match the 2. They're content to trail by 1 at 8-7. Colts 7.
Rigoberto Sanchez to kick off for Indianapolis.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Taken in the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. Man open left side is Brown. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. It's a pickup of from the 40 now on second down. Brady, that's out to his running back, Fournette. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Buccaneers.
Wait, set. Round 80. Round 80. 53. Let's go.
Now a play fake. Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Now how about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great...
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. From the gun, it's Brady. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone, touchdown, Tampa Bay. Antonio Brown there to make the grab. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. A diving catch for the score. He laid out. That was special.
And you know the first thing they're going to check, right? Did he complete the process of the catch? All the way through, all the way to the ground. Ball doesn't hit the ground without control in his hands. All of that, yes. Check the box. Touchdown.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here.
You go tight. You got tight. You got tight right there.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 11 yards there, first down.
Hey, check, 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 check.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, They go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
That's into the hands of Pascal. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Brings up third and two.
Let's go, defense. Let's get out the field, defense. Kill, 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 kill.
And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half.
Hey, kill, 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 kill.
Brissett on first down. Taken in by the tight end, Doyle. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. He gets this into the hands of Taylor. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. 7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down.
A gain of 3. It's now 4th down and less than a yard.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on 4th. Brissett. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. The Colts unable to convert here on 4th down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation...
And is this intercepted? It is! It's intercepted! Picked off by Rocky Sin. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on 1st and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. That's complete to Marlon Mack. And he's brought down after a very nice game. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
The Colts getting the football first, and they trail here as we are back underway in quarter number 3. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
Brings up 3rd and 6.
Watch the curl, watch the curl.
Play action now. Brissett caught left side by Hilton. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a 3rd here, and it's good for a 1st. They go play action with Brissett. He completes this one to Mack. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30.
Here we go.
He got 29 yards that time.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. On the ground, it's Mack. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made that time by Vita Vea.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
On second down, it's Taylor. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. On 2nd and 9, Brady. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. From the gun, Brady. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards. First down. Now from Colts territory, here's a 1st and 10 down at the 31. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. DeForest Buckner using that size to force his way in there and make the stop behind the line. 3 quarters have come and gone. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Buccaneers 15, Colts 10.
13 yards remaining on 2nd down. Operating from the gun, Brady. He's going deep for Brown. And that is caught. Boy, how about that one? He reeled it in one-handed for a touchdown. And Brown only 5'10", but that doesn't mean he can't make spectacular one-handed grabs like that.
He does it all, doesn't he? No matter what you do with Antonio Brown trying to cover him, he finds a way to uncover even late in a route, and a one-handed catch is one way that he does it. Goes up, spears the football, hauls it in. Absolutely amazing. How much strength does that take? And you mentioned it, 5'10", the guys catch it one-handed don't have to be 6'3 or more. They can be Antonio Brown's height if they work at it.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 and the 24. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Now this is Hilton on the receiving end. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Now Brissett. That's complete to Jonathan Taylor out of the backfield.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
A gain of 2. Brings up second and 8. At the 39-yard line.
Brissett. And his throw's going to be incomplete. It was the linebacker Devin White there to knock it away. First down marker at the 31. It's third down.
And 8 yards to go.
To throw, Brissett. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And I think he's gonna go. They're not gonna get him. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Short throw pick six right there, those linebackers. They love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point put through by Succop, and that will make this a 19-point game.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
First and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And that last pick six may have been the backbreaker as they now face a 3-score deficit in the fourth quarter. They need points quickly. They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. That catch good for only a couple. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way. Whoosh.
And he's going to wind up getting this all the way down to the Buccaneers 26. A huge play that time for the Colts. 44 yards on the ground. First and 10, Taylor down. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
He's got Jack Doyle, and they'll get this down to the 10. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there.
Kill.
Off the play fake. Here's Brissett. And Pascal's got it. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Naeem Hines, his first carry. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Only a yard that time, 2nd and goal.
Brings up 2nd and goal.
On 2nd and goal, Brissett to the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
This likely a must-have, 3rd and goal. Out of the gun, Brissett. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
I'm here all day. I'm here all day.
Now Brissett on fourth down. And this is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Bucs defense, they'll celebrate the goal line stand. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got a plane to catch.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and a yard.
Again, it's Jones. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points, that lone field goal, in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage, offense sells tickets. Defense does what?
Wins championships.
And in this game, maybe a championship wasn't won, but a game was by the defense, right? Held them in just a field goal? That's a heck of a job. I mean, when they went out there with that determination and a pretty good game plan, pretty good idea of what they wanted to accomplish, just love the execution, love the tenacity, love the way they finished.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. So long, everybody.